values is strategic. You can't have foreign entities holding the turnkey to systems that we will be deploying for critical infrastructure. That's extremely important. It's true for defense. It's true for energy. It's true for any governmental services. And then there's another aspect, which is we can, by partnering in between the European tech ecosystem and the European leaders, the European champions, we can actually create a lot of value here in Europe. And by creating value, you're bringing new startups, you have people coming, you have new entrepreneurs, you have funds that are coming, and so that compounds. That has compounded for the last 60 years in the Silicon Valley, and we've started to do that. I think we're all like maybe 15 years into the journey, but I'm sure we can go faster if we actually come together as one economic region that wants to create value here.
Jensen, what I really like in what you have said and what Arthur has followed on is that you have not taken the concept of sovereignty from a strategic point of view or from the defense of the interest, but from the cultural aspect. And this is something which speaks a lot to my heart, because when I started to build the global network of publicists, I decided that we should move from, instead of being just international, but deep in each country. And that's the reason why we picked Viva la Différence, because we believe that each country is different. It has its own culture. And I think that is really great that you started from this point of view. When you look at your colleague in the U.S., they are not at all thinking this way. And when you have conversation with Mark and the others, how they are reacting to your approach? Because they consider, for example, that all data can be located in the U.S., there is no issue. They should have access to all data without any offenses or any difficulty, and they should crunch all data of the world without any limitation. When you have those conversations, how do they react?
I haven't had those conversations. It doesn't matter how they react.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I would ask them. I, on first principles, believe that this makes sense. The reason why Europe should build your own AI is because you should build your own intelligence. On first principles, it makes sense.
We can only agree.
I agree. And
I believe, aspect is I believe I should develop my own intelligence.
Yeah.
I believe that I can't rely on somebody else to develop my intelligence. This is something I have to do myself.
So it goes the same for the country.
And yes.
It's not only about the countries, it's also about the enterprises. Yeah. If you're an enterprise today, you have a certain expertise. The people that you've been training for decades actually have grown a specific expertise. They know how to operate the business in a different way than your competitors. And when you're starting to roll AI systems, you need to think about how to put that expertise into the systems. And the only way you're going to be able to do that is to use all of the data that is getting produced by your operations and to make sure that the AI systems can use this data. And so at some point, there's a customization aspect. You want to build your own intelligence, not only at the country level, not only at Europe level, but also at the enterprise level. And also, I should say, at the individual level. What we're building with Le Chat, which is our consumer app, is also personalized.
job.
Monsieur le Président.
Your president worked really hard for you.
Jensen, maybe you can tell to the president why it is important that each nation create its own AI system.
Because you cannot afford to outsource your intelligence. The intelligence of your country and codes and beds, it's people's knowledge, history, culture, common sense, values. That is the definition of intelligence. That intelligence cannot be outsourced. You should do everything in your power to try to advance AI here. Of course, there's nothing wrong with still using public AIs and cloud AIs and such, but you cannot afford to outsource all of it, especially because you have incredible talent here. France, as you and I were having the great conversation about, deep science, deep engineering, deep mathematics. You have the brain trust here. You have the human capital. You have the intellectual capital. We just have to give them the support and the willpower.
It's refreshing, Monsieur le Président. It's refreshing to hear
Luke,
that.
Luke, did you hear that?
It's refreshing.
Maurice, I'm always very happy to be here.
Yes, and we are always very happy to have you.
I'm always very happy to be here, and I have to say that when we started VivaTech, when you started VivaTech, the challenge was to become number one in the world, and you did it. And this is a record this year, so congratulations, really.
It's you. Merci to everyone.
But I have to say, normally I was used to come here and to make a speech for my country, to try to convince people to invest. But this is my very first time with one of the most experienced CEO coming from the US, I mean the best in class, and doing my job. So I can go to bed. I'm finished. But honestly, what Jensen just told us is super important. And what is very important is that having the entire world, but the French ecosystem, hearing that, the fact that we have all these assets, talents, ecosystem, energy, infrastructure, and such a vivid ecosystem of startups, and Arthur is here, obviously, as a frontrunner with Mistral AI, and all these capacities, and he's totally right, this is our fight for sovereignty, for strategic autonomy, which is to say, we want to keep that. We want our cloud, we want our data centers, we want our computing capacities, and we want all the services and infrastructures allowing us to preserve this intelligence, as you perfectly mentioned it, and the diversity. In fact, what we are. And I think the partnership announced today between NVIDIA and Mistral AI is for me an historical one. Ready? And they did a wonderful job because we have, I mean, what Arthur and his team did is absolutely unique, and we want to help them. In February, during the AI summit, we launched a lot of projects to have computing capacities and data centers. And I want to thank all of those who launched MJX and some of those who launched very important projects and additional capacities. But now, with such a global player, number one, going upstream in the system, we create so many synergies and a complete offer which will provide something unique to all those who want to use both Mistral solution and NVIDIA software, NVIDIA solutions, and so on. And it creates the capacity for us to scale up, obviously, but a capacity to build actual French and European offer. And I want to thank you for this trust, and this is the synergies between two of you. And I know that a lot of companies started to commit, so you had the first offsetters. And it was a challenge because we met a few days ago, and the main question of Jensen was to say, will we find big companies committing with us and in fact starting to commit to buy solutions and join us? And in a very few days, I would say, the French and Mistral and NVIDIA teams managed to have a sufficient number of people and very big cookies, I have to say. Some of them are in this room. So it means large companies, top-notch French groups, and they took the commitment and you launched the offer. So I want to congratulate you because this is really a game changer. This is a game changer because it will increase our sovereignty and it will allow us to do much more.
Yeah, congratulations. Nice. Let me say this. I was at the president's office and I was describing this idea. And I told Mr. President that Arthur Mistral needs the support of the largest companies in France. And Mr. President says, who are they? Let me call them.
And we called them.
And he called them. And in just a few days, the great companies of France came out to support Arthur and Mistral. And I think it's fantastic. Now the circulation system, business in France, could be delivered through businesses in France. And this circulation is going to be fantastic for the economy. It's going to be fantastic for starting a young company and getting it bootstrapped. That flywheel will start to go. This is how it happens. And just by asking Mr. President for a little bit of help, he mobilized his team to support us. Thank you.
This means that, Jensen, that you have to come more often, maybe every quarter.
Yes, when I ask for a favor, it really comes through. Anything for the young companies. That's fantastic.
Arthur?
No, it's a great catalyst, and we're very grateful for our launch partners and all of the companies that have agreed to work with us on putting that offer out. And there's multiple French companies, there's also German companies, and I think that's going to be quite important to have this European focus. It will be important because we have much to build. We have things to deploy, we have servers to set up, cables to connect, and we have software to deploy. And so we're grateful that our existing customers, that also companies that we've been working for the last 2 years, are actually supporting that initiative pretty strongly.
I bet never in your wildest dreams when you started Mistral that your president would help you get your customers.
Yeah, it's been very useful. It's been very.
But why? I will tell you, because I think it's super important for obviously our Mistral AI and the company, but it's extremely important for exactly what you said. Because this is a whole ecosystem working together. And we did it for all the startups. Some of them will join us, and a lot of them are in this room. But because we want to be sure that we will be working with European solutions, we want to cooperate with Chinese, American, Korean solutions and so on. But we want to be sure that we will choose this cooperation, but we will not be dependent on them. And it's very important for us precisely because we speak about our intelligence, our brain, our culture, about our history. We want to preserve this level of diversity. And this is exactly what Mistral AI, and it's at the cornerstone, if I may say, of the whole restructuring of the industry. But now we had to secure indeed AI infrastructures. And this is what you provide, and your solutions and your software, and such a global reach that this is a game changer for us because it will allow us to have more clients and to secure precisely all the synergies. And now what we want to do, because I raised a question to Jensen, we want now to go upstream. We would have to have more and more. We do have a lot of companies and French companies working with you when you deploy these capacities, Schneider and so on. You mentioned them during our first meeting. But we want to go upstream and have the packaging of the chips in France and the production and the manufacturing of the chips in France.
Which is when I told Mr. President that NVIDIA's first chip was actually made in France.
And it's very important, because now, since he learned that, I use it all the time to pitch our ecosystem.
1994.
Tell us a story. I think it's very important, because I don't believe that people know.
You didn't know? NVIDIA's story is so well known. In 1994, the company who had the technology to help me to build NVIDIA's first GPU was SGS Thompson, STM, European company. And the fab was in Crolles.
Grenoble.
Okay. Wow.
Still is there.
And coming, and for the story, this is a spin-off from the Leti, and which is a serial lab. So just to see the synergy with the fundamental research and our big research center, and it's a great story. So what we want to do now, because STM still exists, and we have a great ecosystem there. But, I mean, the range of chips they produce is much more for the car industry, I speak under your control, but not for AI. And we want to go, and if we want to consolidate our industry, we have now to get more and more of the chips at the right scale, meaning lower, 2 to 10 nanometers. And we just cooked a deal between Thales, Radial, and Foxconn, and they will create capacities now to make the packaging of chips in France. So we go up some, and now next steps, I want to convince them to make the manufacturing in France to get the whole sovereignty of everything, which will allow us from the chips to the solutions and the startups to have a complete offer. But the deal today that these two guys announced is really a game changer for everybody. And I want to encourage all the large companies, but all the startups as well, to join this team. Why? Because they will make you stronger. They will guarantee you that you have all the solutions you need with safety, European content, cloud in Europe, solutions controlled and produced here on your soil. And you will make them stronger and they will make you stronger, which is exactly how you create synergies in an ecosystem. So, my plea is clearly for all of you in this room and all those who are listening to us to team up with the new team announced this morning between Mistral AI and NVIDIA.
Yeah. And it's, you're the best sales guy.
Yeah. And I should say it's really on us as well to deliver the best technology. There's no such thing as a regional tech leader. And so we've always been very focused to deliver state-of-the-art models, state-of-the-art products, and we'll be focused on delivering state-of-the-art infrastructure as well. So you can trust us. We'll do everything we can, and we can do a lot to make it happen. And so we're very thankful to everybody that has been working with us so far.
Thank you. Arthur and Jensen. Thank you for your participation.
Thank you, Maurice.
It's a pleasure. Thank you so much. Arthur, bravo. Et on compte sur vous.
Hein?
Vous allez casser la baraque. Maybe we have Jensen.